Okay, so I have a confession to make. When I did the facts reference cheat sheet, I struggled a lot with inner brow raiser. It's one of the actions that I frequently struggle with. It's been a 7-year battle. Anyway, I have developed some hacks over the years for how to either simulate the look of inner brow raiser or actually get it to trigger. But before we talk about that, I just want to point out everybody's frontalis moves a bit differently. We have different peaks for our outer brow raiser and our inner brow raise. So it's really important if you're using a model as a reference or yourself as a reference to be aware of where those peaks are. And there's a lot of asymmetries as well. I have them in my face. I'll point them out. So one of the hacks that I've come up with for figuring out your spots, it's gonna require a bit of drawing on the face. So I'm gonna do outer brow raiser because that's my strong point. And that is where I'm gonna isolate the look of my outer brow raiser. Or where's the pull? This is my peak pull, see? All right, now on this side, it's about there. And in fact, it's right at the tip of where my brow hairline is, which is very interesting. So now that we know where the outer brow point is, we can figure out where the inner brow is. One of the hacks that I do for simulating my inner brow is I do a full brow raise, but I sort of push down on the outer brow to keep, not too hard. You have to have a gentle touch. You force the muscle, or you force that area of the muscle to not move. So you're gonna put your fingers down gently, not hard, because then you're gonna create a strange fake looking brow furrow, and we don't want that. So, wow, this is really loud. Okay, we're gonna do a full brow raise with gently touching the outer brow. All right, so this is likely what, if I were to do a nice genuine inner brow, it would look something like this. Okay, let's start with my left. This is how we're gonna determine where the peak of your inner brow is. Okay, so I'm seeing some bulging over here. I'm gonna say that's where that side starts. Now for this side, I'm seeing, there we go. All right, do you see the asymmetry? Look how on my left side, the peak of my inner brow is like directly on the peak of my brow, which is awesome. That makes for a good inner brow raise. But on my right side, look at that gap. That's a lot of space. So the way that that's gonna affect the look of the inner brow raise on my right side is as the inner brow raise pulls up here, this dead area is gonna be just kind of hanging down, and it's only gonna be pulled up by the indirect effect of the pull over at this peak right here. So now that we've got them isolated, you know, the first trick was this. Another thing I do is I'll start with a full brow raise, or I'll start doing the full brow raise with my fingers on my outer brow, and then I'll let go. And like a lot of times it kind of stays, which is awesome. Another hack you can do is if you do a cheek raiser or activate your orbicularis oculi, the lateralis section, because it tightens the ring around your eyes, the band around your eyes, it actually pulls down on the outer corners of your eyebrows. So if you want to put in another action that will facilitate your inner brow raiser better, or at least make it look more exaggerated, is if you do, it keeps down the outer portions of your brow, keeps them taut. Some other brow stuff. First let me do some little poses for you with the peaks on. All right, so doing outer, different angle. All right, I'm gonna try to do inner. That asymmetry really, really bugs. Also, mind you, I'm still struggling to separate out the outer brow raise, so if you're going to use this as a reference, keep that in mind. Watch the peaks. Okay, so now I'm gonna do inner. add outer. Inner, add outer. All right. We'll talk about these combinations with furrow another time. I have a lot to say about brow furrow. And I'm going to just call brow furrow AU4 because there's about 3 muscles associated with furrowing your brow, and I'm not going to list all of them. And also, there is a lot of different facial morphology where some people don't even have some of those muscles. Anyway, next. So besides the way your muscle pulls your brow, another thing that greatly affects the look of your inner brow raise and outer brow raise and full brow raise is actually your hair distribution. Where your hair lies on your face, as in, when does this start? When does this start? Like, how close is it to your nose? How high up are your brows? How low set are they? What kind of curve do you have? A curve? Do you have a straight brow? What is the angle like? For example, like, what if I had my peak of my eyebrows out here and then my outer brow raise would be over here? That would be that would give it a different look. Some people, the ones who have straight brows that are slightly angled up, their inner brow raises look really nice. But because my brows are curved with a low set over here, it's not as clean, especially with that asymmetry. But due to the power of makeup, you can manipulate your face or your model's face. Or in fact, when you're doing your character design, if you want to make a character look more empathetic, you can design their brows to have a shape more like this. So in order to reduce the exaggerated look of my curved brow, I'm gonna add some bulk to the medial portion of my brows to reduce the look of that curve. And then we can compare the difference between how my brows were looking before I added this and then how they look after. All right. If you never wanted to watch a makeup tutorial, too bad. Sometimes you just gotta do it in the name of science, you know? I personally don't wanna watch makeup tutorials either, but I wanna know about the face. That looks really horrifying, but it's not the point. Okay, just gonna blend it a bit, you know? Ooh, look at that already. I'm seeing some good differences in inner brow. Okay. Oh, that side's more angled. Gotta fix the right side. We're almost there, I swear. You could do this too. You could draw on your face. It's really fun. It's like a light massage. Disregard the unevenness and the bushwhacker thickness of the tips of my brows, but I just admire the inner brow. Raise looks a lot stronger now. So, inner, outer. My outer brow still looks very prominent. So I'm gonna do full brow raise. It's a bit more squared off now. So it'd probably be good for your brows. You're gonna full brow raise and add some furrow. Okay. Attempting to do inner. Oh yeah, that looks a lot better than before. So it's not just the muscle morphology, it's also the hair distribution that's really important. And a lot of these things work together collectively. In fact, most things are collective. I'm a big proponent of a collective approach to the face. This was Melfax Monday, my first video. Thank you for watching. I will be posting new content, whether it's in video, photo, or GIF form. And yes, I say GIF, not GIF, because I go with the linguistic rules, not peanut butter rules. So see you next Monday. Follow either Twitter or LinkedIn to stay most updated. That's where I'll be advertising any updates or new content.